Welcome everybody to the show Study in Slovakia, where, believe it or not, we are talking about studying in Slovakia. I know. Ooh, the country of Slovakia. And we are sponsored by the website studyinslovakia.sk. They're a recruiting agency that will help to get students to Slovakia. And it doesn't just, it's not just, oh, help me, and then you get here and nothing happens. They will help you with foreign police, paperwork, credits. And if you're even crying and you're sad and you need somebody to talk to you, they will help. So whatever you need, studyinslovakia.sk. So with that, are you ready to start the interview?
Yeah, we can start.
Tell the millions of people around the world, who are you?
So, my name is Adam and I'm from Slovakia. I was raised in Košice and I'm studying medicine here at the University of Pavel Jozef Šafárik. I'm studying general medicine study program in Slovak language. And I will hopefully end in next year, so I will be in my sixth year of study, like in the next academic year. So during my studies, I joined many like student organization clubs and some like extracurricular activities, mostly like parliaments and student organization that was aimed for some public health, sexual and reproductive health, human rights, and other kind of stuff.
So you said you did a little bit of student congress. Like, what is that like?
So in my second or first year, I don't remember exactly, we organized congress in Košice. It was called International Student Medical Congress in Košice. Mm-hmm. It was like really fun, but really hard to organize for us. Next couple of years, I went to congresses as participants. We didn't organize a congress in Košice anymore. So I was on some congresses that are general assemblies, mm-hmm. and general assemblies of International Federation of Medical Student Associations. It's like the biggest organization that covering like all medical students in the entire world. So I was there. I was in Taiwan and I participated in AME. It's like it's Medical Education Congress, but I do not know the first letter because they changed the name and they kept the like abbreviation, and it's so weird now. Like Medical Education Congress, like the biggest in the world, it was in Vienna. So I'm trying to do my best, like do some extracurricular activities and some interesting stuff, not only to study. I do think that it's important for all the students not only to study, but to have something like to chill, but to do something, like to do some work, but to do it for fun, and to do it for you are enjoyed by it and that kind of stuff. Not only to study, because you will have like, I think, some depression or psyche problem if you will only study the entire day, because they are some type of student that do that, like mm-hmm. they're only studying. Do not think it's good for them, for their like personal development or something like that. I think that it's important to do other stuff at university.
I just said I wanted to agree with you the importance of doing a lot of activities, because a lot of the students I saw throughout all our years, we are like the same year. I'm in the foreign program, he's in the Slovak program, and I've seen it. Like, a lot of the students who fail, I mean, there's the aspect of those who party too much and like don't have a good balance, but then there's those who just study and it's like the grind of school. If you don't have any like escape valve, it eats you up. Like, I've seen most of the successful people over the years, just like you did so many different activities.
Yeah, but we have to mention that it's important to study as well.
Yeah, just
not only partying and doing extracurricular activities. You have to study, but you have to like find the right way how to mm-hmm. like to have a right time management and to study, but not only study, to have fun, to partying. It's important too, I think, at university. You are young, mm-hmm. and you have to party. You like to meet a lot of people, to enjoy your free time. And it's a good way, in my point of view, it's a good way to do some activities that are beneficial for your like surroundings, for your environment, or mm-hmm. whatever you want to. Because these activities are beneficial for the others, and but they are beneficial for you too, for your personal development. Because you see that a lot of people that studied or graduated or are studying like at this time, they have like a lot of knowledge, like a lot of information. They're pretty smart, but they do not have like speaking skills and and this kind of communication skills, time management, and it's hard to do a doctor, I think. I'm not a doctor, but I think it will be hard to do a doctor without this kind of skills.
So let's dive into balancing everything, because that's what we've been talking about so far. So like, how has that changed for you from first year to now? Like, how did you learn, what did you have to do to try to get a good balance of everything? What adjustments did you have to make?
Yeah, if you want to do something like not only to study, but you want to enjoy that what we talk about, you have to make some adjustments, you have to sacrifice something. Then first thing you have to do is to like put the value to every 1 hour of your day. Mm-hmm. So you will say that, yeah, okay, these 2 or 3 hours I'm doing, I do not know, I'm like playing computer games. So you have to say to yourself that, is it worth it to do it, or can I skip these hours, mm-hmm. or can I just play video games 1 hour a day, and the other hours I can use for something beneficial, or something that is enriching me, or some self-development. But day has like 24 hours, so sometimes you have to sacrifice something more. So I had to sacrifice like part-time jobs and jobs at all. I didn't have time to do any like part-time jobs. One important thing I want to say is that do not forget for your personal life, like yeah. for relationships, for family. Keep some time for family and like romantic relationships or flirting and that kind of stuff, because it's important too. And that's usually the first thing that people like sacrifice if they do not have a time. And I did it for maybe 1 year, and it was like really yeah. time, like bad time.
I want to ask, I know this is going to be a little complicated question mm-hmm. in terms of studying, but in your best words for the average person, how much do you think you study, like let's say during the year and then during exam season? Like how much do you think you study on a day-to-day basis, you think?
The more important is if you know how to study, mm-hmm. not the time you will study, but if you know how to study the subject, it's more important than the time itself. At least I think that. And in exam period, it's like you need to study more, or you will study more during like a school,
yeah.
During semester, but you can study in exam period. It's possible even in medical school. A lot of people say that it's not possible to learn for exam, to study for exam only in exam period, but it's possible.
Yeah.
Like you can do that, but it's really hard, and you really need the support from your like surroundings to be able to do that, because in exam period you will not doing anything than only studying entire your time. I had like exam period that I studied maybe 10-12 hours a day, so it was like crazy. Only sleeping, eating and studying, but I need my mother to cook, to bring the food, to wash the dishes. So it's difficult if you will studying only during exam period, but it's possible. It's up to some student, like some particular students, to choose the best way how she or he will study and how she or he will pass the subject. So it's up to everyone, but for me it's like I studied 2 or 3 hours a week, And during exam period, it was like crazy for me because I had like a lot of activities in exam period. So I need to pass my exams as early as possible. So I had a lot of preterms and a lot of first terms. So it was like crazy for me, but you can do it otherwise.
Yeah, no, I think you summed it up because it's like you basically have the choice. It's like, do you want to pay now during the semester or you pay during the exam period? I mean, like you said, like I've seen a lot of people do it. There's no right answer to it, but yeah, it just depends on what works best for you.
Yeah, I think it's good to have the choice because we are not in kindergarten or in middle school or something like that. Yeah. You have the freedom to like to study anytime you want. You have the freedom to not to study, but you will not pass, but it's your decision to do that, and you are not like it's not compulsory for you to study. The teachers will be okay with that. They will give you like F or something, and you will not pass, but they will not like push you to study.
Yeah, that's basically growing
and
up.
I think it's like a good way to do it, like to teach and to study. It's up to students to study, not up to teachers.
Okay, and I definitely agree with that. So. So since you're on your last year of school, what do you think has changed the most for you these past 6 years? Like, how have you changed since you were a freshman?
In first year, I was like, it was like really hard for me to like to swap from high school studying and to university. Mm-hmm. It was something different, and I had to find my way how to study like efficiently. It was like first 2 months they were like really problematic, but I found my way how to study, when to study. It's an important thing to mention, and I just keep it like to today. Like I'm studying the same way, like but it's different way than in high school. Mm-hmm. I'm just changing that, and I began to understand some quotes and some speeches of professors and people from academic field that I really didn't believe in my first year, and I thought that it's like nonsense or something like that. But I'm agreeing with it like now, so there are quotes that you are just arguing with the teachers that I do not need to learn these because I will be a doctor, not like scientist, or I will not do nature science. And you are like telling them that no, I don't need it, and you'll figure out in like the last year and fifth year that you need it, and they were right that they taught you that. And of course I understand more like medical science, and I understand the terms. Know if like doctors are talking about some topic, I understand more, and it's like really surprising for me because it came like in 1 second I didn't understand like any of the text on the medical papers, and now I understand most of it, and it's like really interesting, and I'm just enjoying it that I know it, like I at least I know how to read it and what does it mean.
Well, like I mean, like I think the funny part about being in the medical environment is it's challenging because it's like when I go to school, it's like I just felt stupid every single day. It's like the professor is king or queen. They know so much more than you. And I felt like for so many years, I didn't know anything. But then it's like when you talk to an average person about medicine, it's like, whoa. How come you don't know about rabies or vaccinations? How do you not know that? It's like you feel stupid, but when you go to the real world, your science knowledge is like exponentially more than the average person. It's just weird being in the school. You're like confused, but then out in the real world, it's like, oh my goodness, people think I know a lot.
Yeah, but you do not realize it until the moment you are like talking with people, and you are just, I know what they are saying, and I know something about it. I remember something from the subject. I think that I thought that I will not remember like nothing. I will remember nothing.
Yeah.
And I remember something that they told me something about this topic. It's interesting. It's really interesting, and I hope that a lot of you will will have this kind of like emotions and like really good.
So you as a Slovak man, I want you to tell the audience, why should somebody come and study in Slovakia?
I think Slovakia is a good country to come here because of academic staff. Not all of them, but some of them are really great. So I think if you are a foreign student and if you are like, if you want to go to study abroad, then Slovakia is a good choice if you want to do like a practical medicine, if you want to be a doctor, like some kind of doctor you will choose. One good thing for Slovakia is that we do not have like very strict rules about like patient-student contacts. We have that a lot of like contacts with patients, and I never studying in another country, but that I do not know if it's true or not, but a lot of our professors said to us that it's not really often for the students to like to have so much contact with the patients in Slovakia. So you will see the diagnosis, you will see diseases like the ordinary one, because we have a lot of patients in here with this ordinary disease. So you will be better prepared for a practical part of medicine. If you want to be like a crisis scientist in medical field, I do not know if it's the best way, but you can do it as well. But for every doctors, I think our university is good, our medical faculty.
Also, make sure to check out the website studyinslovakia.sk if you have any questions about trying to make it as a student in this country. My name is Peter, and you guys take care.